Today I want to show you how you can use blocks made from crumb fabric in quilt projects. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst of chatterboxquilt.com. And before we get into today's topic, I'd love it if you would subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I release a new video. Now, in previous videos, I showed you how to make crumb fabric, and I also showed you how to make three different blocks from that fabric. And if you haven't seen those videos and you don't know what I'm talking about, check in the description below because I put links to both those videos there. But quickly, crumb fabric is where you take little pieces of scrap fabric and you stitch them together to make a bigger piece of fabric. So you might get something that looks like this. And then what do you do with that? Well, that's where the other video comes in, where I showed you three different blocks you could make with that fabric. And today I'm working with one of them. This is what I call a slash and insert block. You take a background piece of fabric and you cut it, slash it, and then you put an insert in that is made from that crumb fabric. You can call these sticks. Some people call them that. I like to call them pieces of fabric, pieces of crumb fabric. So we'll call them sticks to make it easier. Now, there's a few things to keep in mind when you're making this block. First off, the size of it. So this particular one, I started with a piece of background fabric that was 4.5 inches in size. It's going to be a 4-inch square when I'm finished. And I want to be careful of a couple things. First off, when I am cutting the background piece apart, I want to be careful of the width of the piece I'm putting in, the stick I'm putting in, because this is a really small piece of background fabric. So I don't want to put a huge stick in it, okay? It's not a stick in the mud, it's a stick in the background block, but I want to be careful of the width. So I would suggest for a block this size that my stick I insert would be no wider than 1 inch. If it becomes larger than that, what happens is your stick starts taking over the background. You're going to have more of that crumb fabric, that all those different pieces together, you're going to have more of that in there than the background fabric, and that's really not the effect we're going for. Also, you want to be careful how many sticks you're putting into your block. I could put another one in here. I could sew in the first stick, and then I could cut it again and put in another stick. But when this block is the size it is, which is the 4.5 inches, you do not want to put too many sticks in, because again, it'll start looking like a bit of a jumbled mess. Too much of all this fabric going on. But as you get into blocks that are bigger, if you're working with, say, a 12-inch block, for example, you could certainly put more sticks in. You might want to even put 3 of them in. And typically, you would put them, you know, across each other. You could put them next to each other on different angles. It all depends on how you cut or slash that background block. But just keep in mind the width of the stick you're putting in and how many you're putting in for the size of your block. Okay, just wanted to put that out there before we go any further. So now that I've got this little block made, or several of them made, what am I going to do with it? Well, I've mocked up a few examples in EQ8 to give you some ideas of what you can do with this type of block. So let's take a look at those. Now, if you have smaller blocks like the one I just showed you, you could stack them up side by side in pairs, just like they're going into the arc, right? And then you can have those pairs stacked on top of one another with that negative space on both sides. So you could create a quilt or a smaller project, such as maybe a table runner. If you've got bigger blocks, you can use those and put sashing in between the blocks to quickly make up a larger quilt. So let's say you had maybe 12-inch blocks, so you could just add some sashing in there and quickly create a good size quilt. And you could even use some of that crumb fabric as cornerstones. You could cut squares out of it and use it in the sashing and in the border as cornerstones, and that would give some additional interest too. Now, depending on the fabrics you've used in your crumb fabric, and you'd have to be a little intentional about this, you could get the look of birch trees in your project. So in this wall hanging example, I've added 3 sticks, or I've cut through 3 times to get into the background fabric, and added 3 insert strips or sticks that run from the bottom to the top of that background block, and it gives the impression of trees. So if you were using dark colors like browns and blacks with some whites in there, you could get the look of, say, a birch tree, for example. So you could also add darker colored fabric strips to give some dimension. You could give some depth to it if you wanted, making them look like they're further away if you use dark colored fabric for those inserts. And when I think of inserting these sticks, I usually think of inserting them as in a vertical way, but you could also put them in horizontally, and that creates a whole different look. So always be thinking about how you could put those inserts in and what kind of a look it will give you. But those are just a few examples to start your creative juices flowing. So I hope this gave you some ideas of what you can do with that slash and insert block with the crumb fabric in it. I hope it got your creative juices going a bit. They are kind of fun to use. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your quilting friends. And for more helpful quilting information, go to www.chatterboxquilts.com.